Hi, I'm Dr. Daniel Kantor, president of the Florida Society of Neurology. MS can affect a lot of different symptoms. We talk a lot about disease progression, we talk about relapses, but we have to talk about individual symptoms. A lot of people with MS say they have problems sleeping. So I'm so happy to be here joined by an expert who actually just gave a lecture on this topic, on sleep disorders in multiple sclerosis. We're joined again by Dr. David Brandes, who's a neurologist at the Hope MS Center in Knoxville, Tennessee. So my question is, what are the types of sleep disorders we see in MS, and what should someone do if they think they are having a sleep problem?
Well, there are many, obviously, and many MS patients complain of being tired or fatigued in the daytime. MS itself can cause fatigue, but there are many other causes, medication effects and so on, but sleep disorders are often unrecognized. Sleep disorders include things like sleep apnea, where you stop breathing during the night, leg twitching or jerking during the night, trouble with urination, having to get up frequently at night, all sorts of things that disturb sleep and cause daytime tiredness or sleepiness. It's often not recognized by the physicians because they're not trained in sleep disorders. Okay. Very few physicians have any training at all in sleep disorders. So I think the patients really need to talk to their doctors about what they mean by tiredness. Are they sleepy in the daytime, fatigued in the daytime, depressed in the daytime, cognitively slowed down, different things. And these sleep disorders can be diagnosed and treated, and I think that's the most important thing. What we see is that MS itself can cause some problems, for example, the bladder problems or the leg twitching. Okay. On the other hand, it may be something totally separate, not related to MS. It may be sleep apnea, which is much more common than we used to think. Sometimes sleep apnea is caused by MS because of muscular weakness in the back of the throat, but more often not. And most patients, when they have sleep apnea, don't know it. They don't know why they are not feeling good in the daytime, because it only stop breathing only during the time that they're asleep. They don't recognize it. So very often the bed partner, the spouse, will tell the person, yes, you do snore at night, yes, you do stop breathing at night, and I'm even worried about you sometimes. And the patient doesn't believe it. But it's really important that you talk to your doctor about that.
Now tell me, what is sleep hygiene? We've heard this term. What is sleep hygiene?
Sleep hygiene has to do with your actual going to sleep at night. For example, some obvious things may be trying to go to sleep with the television on. Okay. If the television is on, you keep waking up during the night. You get poor quality sleep. If you go to sleep in a room that's very hot, not cooled down, that can be very uncomfortable. If you have a child in bed with you and a dog in bed with you, or you know, who knows, all sorts of things, they can also disturb your sleep. So what we're going to do is clean up sleep, make it hygienic. That is, when you're in bed, you're there only to go to sleep. You're not there to watch TV, you're not there to read, work on your computer, you're there for sleep.
Yeah, we know the bedroom is used for really two things, and one of them is sleep.
That's right. So those are the two things, and that's what you need to do. Clean up your sleep patterns so that you use the bed only for sleep and for sex.
Okay, so clean up your sleep habits, and make sure to talk to your neurologist and describe the type of sleep problem you're having. Is it that you feel sleepy during the day? Is it that you feel rest in the morning? Is it not this or that? I want to thank you so much, Dr. Brandes, for joining us.
You're welcome. Thank you.